So first of all, thank you all for being here and for honoring Bernie Buller, our friend. This is a wonderful, wonderful way to come together and celebrate such an amazing listener. Bernie listened to songs like nobody that I've ever met. I mean, he was so tuned in and would give feedback to artists after the show. Like it or not, exactly. But he would come up, and I'm sure you're gonna hear a lot of stories tonight about comments that Bernie made about songs that you might play. And I'll tell one of those in just a minute as well. First, I wanna just give a big acknowledgement to Julie Zipperer and Ed Brand for really putting this thing together. Amazing. What a special gathering this is. I just don't remember anything quite this special. This is really great to see you all. So let's see. I also heard from other artists who couldn't be here that wanted to be here. Michael McNevin in particular wanted to send me some words to read, and I said, Mike, we don't have time for that. I'm sorry. As you know, Mike can go on. Phil Ward sent his best. He would love to be here tonight to honor Bernie, but could not. He was working, couldn't make it. So, let's see. Julie, you've got the clipboard. I'm going to do a song and then bring up Alexia, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you then quickly. And a big thank you to our staff here at the Lost Parrot, of course. Dale and Mark and Mel, thank you guys. They decided, usually they serve food here on Wednesday nights, and we decided there were too many people. We can't do that. So we have some pizzas out front, mostly for the performers, but I think if you know anybody, you can work your way into some of that. So this is a song that Ed Tree and I recorded years ago, and it was intended to be on one of my albums, and we cut it from the lineup, and I played it at a wine and song show, and Bernie came up to me afterward and said, that's the best song I've ever heard you play. Why isn't that on a record? And I said, well, it was supposed to be, but it didn't make the lineup. So the next album came around, and it was in the mix of songs being considered for the next album again, and again it didn't make it. And each time this happened, it happened four times that it got cut from the lineup, and each time Bernie, you know, showed his extreme disappointment with me when he looked at the list of songs on the album, and it wasn't there. So for him, I play this song tonight. It's called The Long Forgotten Wall. Favorite magazine. He'd pretend not to notice her and go about his work, turning an old brick wall into an artist's dream. And every single afternoon, he couldn't wait to see the beauty that inspired him each day. He tried to memorize her every in his mind, till she gathered up her things and rode away. And she rode on a breeze through the patch of cypress trees that he placed on the mural, a
that long forgotten wall. And he would fly like a seagull for a few precious minutes, till she gathered up her things and rolled away. One day he asked her kindly for an hour of her time to put her lovely likeness on the wall. Well, she'd never been so flattered, she graciously agreed. He draped her in the bluest velvet shawl, and every single minute was as endless as the sky. When their eyes would meet, she'd blush and look away. He painted her into the very center of his heart. He painted what his words would never say. And she rolled on the breeze through a patch of cypress trees that he placed on the mural of that long forgotten wall. And he would fly like a seagull for a few precious hours, till she gathered up her things and rolled away.
Say a few words. Thank you, Alexia.
This is one live? This is live. So those of you who know me, mostly know me as a dancer, which actually was my first career. But for the last 35 years, I've been a pastor. So at moments like this, when they want someone to say a few words, they usually ask me. And what came to me, I've been thinking about Bernie all day. And what came to me was first a quote, that the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness does not overcome it. And that sentiment is at the root of the celebrations of Jews and of Christians at this time of the year. But it's also at the root of all memorials, because every person, in their own way, brings a light into the world, right? They bring warmth, they bring a perspective or some wisdom that illuminates our lives. And that was certainly true of Bernie. Amen? Can I say amen? And I was thinking, you know, that song fits it so well. what Brady gave to me, that he used to tell a story, and I'm sure he told that story to many of you, about being in his 50s and falling hopelessly in love with somebody. And he never tells exactly how it ended, but he always just said, you know, I let her go. I never should have let her go. And he would say to me, hold on to the people you love and don't let them go. And that was a light he gave me. So most of you, if not all of you, should have a little candle. Many of you have already been playing around with it, trying to figure out how to light it. It's not that hard. You take the top part and you turn it like this. Right? So what I want you to do is to take a minute to think about a way that Bernie was a light in your life. Either warmth that he brought you or perspective that he brought you. And when you come up with something, when you come up with a memory, turn on your little light and hold it. So I'd like to ask you to do that now. So this room is now full of the light of Bernie. The light that he brought us, the light that we want to carry on in our lives. And I want to ask you, this is for you to take home, that when you're at home, if you feel like it, you know, over the next few weeks, turn it on and remember him. Let his light shine. Now I'm going to close with a very short prayer, and for those of you who don't pray, just take a moment of silence of remembering Bernie. So let's take that time. Giver of all goodness of life, we remember Bernie with such gratitude. May his light continue to shine through us who loved him. Amen.
I wrote a song for Bernie in his memory because I needed extra credit in this course. Also, I wanted to thank Brad for inviting us to have this At Wine and Song because he just stepped up and offered that. And so thank you, Brad.
Something's just not right. Someone's missing tonight. There's a dimming of the light and a heaviness in the air. We have lost a friend. So we strike up the band and we leave the chair. Leave.
beautiful song, Marty. Thank you. And we've left the chair, as you can see, for Bernie. I hope you all got a chance to see the piece that Ed Brand photoshopped together. Come on up, Tracy, and we'll get you dialed in. But we're going to turn this chair around now so that Bernie can see the show.
And so that the performers can see Bernie seeing the show. Do you have your lead?
Yeah.
She's got it. Hi. Tracy Newman. Is that amplified? My God. I haven't plugged in.
The right button. Hit multiple buttons.
Bernie came to a lot of shows that I did, but that's because I played with a lot of you guys. And, you know, he just was always there. And he had several favorite songs of mine, which always pleased me. But I have to say, I'm pretty sure this was his favorite. And most of you have heard it, but maybe there are some here who didn't. Shift he's here now and then. He orders coffee and takes out a pen. I offer him paper. No, this napkin is fine, says the man at table 9. He asks me my age. I'm 21. He smiles and says, how'd you get to be so young? I call him a flirt. He calls me sunshine. A man at table 9. Table 9's in the back by the payphone. There's always somebody whispering to me. You know you're waiting on the Okie from Muskogee. I don't know or even ask what that means. He just looks like a cowboy, kinda haggard and gray. They say he's a singer, folks pay him to play. But I can't imagine standing in line to see the man at table 9.
Says every line I
the napkin and ask him to sign. And when I get home, I'm gonna find him online. The man at table 9. Thank you so much. Am I supposed to introduce somebody?
Tim's coming.
Oh, okay. Here they come.
Introduce Tim Tedrow.
Tim Tedrow.
Oh, right. Tim Tedrow. Oh. There he is.
Okay, we'll keep it short. I don't have a whole lot of Bernie stories. I knew him for about 30 years, and this was his favorite of my songs. If I set my soul to fly, would you hear my voice take wing? Would the calling of an open heart make you find your way to me? Seems to me I've been searching for a lifetime. Just don't have the strength to carry on. But I know you're out there. I can hear your soul calling mine. I know you're out there. You've been looking for me all this time. When the sun shines, you warm me. You must find me.
Yeah.
so hard to find. You must find me. You've given me no choice. You must find me.
Being together and singing music together, so I hope you'll take a shot at singing it with me. The chorus goes like this.
Take me back singing with you and our friends who would always sing along in those basket houses and coffee bars where we gather together in song.
So for those you don't know, a basket house is a place where people pass the basket from the singers. So sing with me, JK, we'll do it one more time and learn the song.
Take me back to singing with you and our friends who would always sing along in those basket houses and coffee bars where we'd gather together in song. On a December night, a quiet street, freezing as I ducked inside that bar. Laughed as I was brushing the snow out of my beard and asked if I would get out my guitar. I started to play an old one that I knew and right away joined in harmony. It only took a moment for the sound of your voice to become a forever part of me. Take me back to singing with you.
My friends would always sing along.
Friends would always sing along.
Those basket houses and coffee bars.
In those basket houses and coffee bars.
Where we gather.
Cafe club, I was watching your lips so carefully. from my door. Take me back to singing with you, and our friends who would always sing along in those basket houses and coffee bars where we joined together in our song. Last December, I wandered down that same icy street. All the things that I remember song I sing with you, but now it's faded in the hazy past. Sometimes late at night when I'm standing on the stage, I feel a voice stood right next to me, and I hear your voice rising in the air.
Green Eyes, and I'm going to be joined here by a brother and sister team, Leslie and Tim Barker. Here we go, Kate Wolf's Green Eyes.
Thing. They only last. Wow, boy, it's nice to see all you here. It's quite a tribute to Bernie. I wanted to also thank Carol Moss and also Karen Lambert, Bernie's daughter, who are both here tonight. And they were really instrumental in helping to put this all together, too. This is one of Bernie's favorite songs.
Each other's arms, a warm stillness took us
in love, there was no more to say. A glance from you now will light up my face. The world seen through love is a much better place. The first I love you, I whispered in doubt. Made a world I can't imagine living without. A world I can't live without.
Good evening. My name is Ken Holm. At least that's what my parents told me at least. Anyway, Bernie, this song I'm about to do has something in common among the songs I wrote that he likes. This is the one he didn't dissect and hand me back in a slightly different order. It's also very short, which fits an evening full of performers. This is called Harold Who Is Big. If you know the words, sing along, because that's what it was built for. Hi, Bernie. Harold Who Is Big is a kitty. Harold Who Is Big is a cat. Harold Who Is Big is a 20-pound mouser, but Harold Who Is Big isn't fat. Harold Who Is Big is a big bad cat. Hey, what do you think about that? Yeah, Harold Who Is Big has a big fuzzy body, but you'd never mistake him for a rat or a meatloaf. Harold Who Is Big thinks he's tiny. Harold Who Is Big is built like a tank. Harold Who Is Big is a lover, thank God, 'cause he ain't the kind of thing you can spank. Harold Who Is Big runs the alley. Harold Who Is Big is the cat land head. Regular sized cats do what Big Harold says, or they just might end up dead. When Big Harold meows, you'd expect a big meow that might jump to the house or the bed. But when Big Harold meows, he doesn't shake the ground, he just says meow instead. Who's next? So, honey?
Karina Carter.
Who?
Karina Carter.
Okay. Karina Carter, come on down.
Okay, I'm going to talk real fast because I know there's a lot of people to get up here. So I've been practicing this song on a little recording that I had, and Bernie was in the audience, and I forgot the words. Forgot the words on the first verse. And as I was listening to the song over and over again so I could make sure I got the words right, I could swear I could hear Bernie's voice saying, "To walk around in Hollywood," because that's the part of the song that I forgot. And I thought, and that was so like Bernie. If he knew the words to the songs that he liked. And he knew all the words to this song. So anyway. This is a Michael McNevin song. Ed Tree's gonna play with me on it. I'll represent Michael. This is a beautiful song about Michael's mother.
Sorry.
so Bernie loved the you know, the tender story songs, and so this was one of his favorites. This is called Margaret, 1956.
So the last
last time I played this song, it was a Wine and Song, and I was gonna had my set planned out. And Bernie said, "Hey, would you do this song?" And I said, "Well, of course, I'll do this song." So tonight I'm gonna do it again for Bernie. I don't think there was a better listener of any audience that I've ever seen. He would you'd play a new song, and he would come up to you and talk to you about the lyric and ask you about something and want to hear whatever that you were working on. He was just a really special, wonderful guy, and I always liked that he didn't just like my songs. He would give me crap about stuff that he could be better. So I appreciate that. You gotta love Bernie. Let me get this off my headstock here. Love you, man. I can't find you anywhere. I've looked everywhere I know. Have you vanished in the air? I can't imagine where you'd go. I can't find you anywhere. I wish I knew you were okay. So I say a silent prayer, and I hope it's not too late. Did you somehow lose your way? Have you had a change of heart? Wish I could tell you how I feel tonight, but I don't know where you are. I can't find you anywhere. Feels like part of me has died. Wish I could bring you back from there, but I don't know where you hide. I can't find you anywhere, and you're right here by my side. So Bernie,
stage pattern to a minimum here. Bernie, knew him for decades, loved him, and I was, you know, my forebears, my dad's side came from the Plains of Abraham up in Canada, so I love Canadians, and I just love Canada, and he definitely was that. And he told me that he knew Gordon Lightfoot back in the 60s, early 60s, in the Yonge Street days up in Toronto. And I said, "Yeah, okay, sure." And then, when I finally met Gordon Lightfoot, Bernie was right by my side. And the first thing Gordon said was, "Bernie!" So I'm gonna do a Gordon Lightfoot song. It's not about Bernie, but he liked it. And when I say that he liked it, that means that when I played my version of it, he goes, "That was good." Him more than anybody here. Okay, so here we go. Sometimes I play this song and I go, "I wrote that." Mm-hmm.
could read my mind, love, what a tale my thoughts could tell. Just like an old-time movie about a ghost from a wishing well, in a castle dark or a fortress strong, with chains upon my feet. No, that ghost is me. And I will never be set free as long as I'm a ghost you can't see. If I could read your mind, what a tale my thoughts could tell. Just like a paperback novel, the kind the drugstore sells. When you reach the part where the heartaches come, the hero would be me. But heroes often fail. You won't read that book again because the ending's just too hard to take. Like a movie star who gets burned in a three-way script. Enter number two. Movie queen to play the scene of bringing all the good things out in me. But now, love, let's be real. Never thought I could in this way. And I've got to say, just don't get it. I don't know where we went wrong, but the feeling's gone, and I just can't get it back. If you could read my mind, what a tale my thoughts could tell. Just like an old time movie about a ghost from a wishing well, in a castle dark or a fortress strong, with chains upon my feet. The story always ends. If you read between the lines, you will know that I'm just trying to understand the feelings that you left.
Was on the strike lines with my fellow WGA and SAG members playing rousing songs of Union Solidarity.
Communist songs.
Communist songs. We were communists. And John was right with me. Fighting off the bulls, you know, and the thugs with their fist-cured hams, and their blackjacks, and their truncheons. Right, Tracy? We were there. Union. Okay, anyway, sorry. John Kennedy, thank you. And thanks for having me here. Up next is probably one of the finest guitarists in Los Angeles, and my dear friend, Barry Tagler.
Alright, well, everywhere you went, you know, I play all over the place. I played, you know, you go to Kulak's, there's Bernie. You go to Julie's joint, there's Bernie. You go to Coffee Gallery, there he is. Go to Matt Denny's, every place. So I can't go anywhere for a while now without turning around and going, well, where is he? You know, that's going to be hard. I know we got to keep things moving along here. So I'm going to do a ballad that the kind he liked. This is a song, the thing to know about it is there's two characters, two guys. One's named Miguel, and the other one is named Michael. So that can be a little confusing. Thank you, Brad, for the tuned guitar. Cool.
Looks nice on you.
Me llamo Miguel, before God, I am humble as my name. A prayer for luck, few humble belongings, nameless I came. For a lonely year I worked from dawn to dark, move from farm to farm. Now I carry kegs of beer and sweep the broken glasses in this bar. I save every penny to send home to my beautiful wife. Someday our children have some kind of life, like these people here dancing so free, too busy having fun to see. They're the lucky ones. They're the lucky ones. My name is Michael. I've been played for a fool. The ex-wife killed my will, my son's killing time in a boarding school. In this place where we pay too much for booze, sometimes we hook up, then forget who we were with by the time we wake up. No one will notice when one day I disappear. Not like the guy who sweeps up and carries in the beer. And kids who run to the door, pull him down by his arms to roll around on the floor. They're the lucky ones. They're the lucky ones. They're he was.
That guitar sounds really good when you play it. I don't know. Barrett Taglarino. Hey, we're going to take a short break, everybody. I know this is a bit of a marathon program, but I think they need to sell some more drinks here. Thank you, Mel and Mark and Dale, for working this night for us. And we just want to thank the Lost Parrot, because they've been a wonderful place to have Wine and Song here for the last few months. So we're going to have a short break. We'll be back with Janie Thorne in just a second, and lots more. Thanks, everybody.